All right, so I'm going to talk about electronics and how to hook everything up. Once you have the structure all together, hooking up all of the little switches and so forth. So there's not enough clearance on the holes in this Arduino Mega board for the standards head, so I had to grind that one off. I had to grind both sides of this one just to get it in there. This is the M4 by 22. My ramps board. My stepper motors have 6 wires instead of 4. I guess the standard is 4, and that's for a bipolar stepper. This is a unipolar, but it will work. You basically just discard the center tap. There's 2 coils, so red and yellow is a coil, and the black is a center tap. We'll throw that one out. And blue and orange is a coil, and then we'll throw away this white one. I'll show you how I figured that out. Alright, so we take an ohm meter and we go between yellow and red here. You can see that's about 7 ohms. But if we go from red to black, it's going to be half of that. Well, it's about 3 ohms. Then when we go from yellow to black, it's 3 ohms. Well, you'll notice that these 3 wires here are not tied in any way to these on the left. So these on the left will do blue and orange. So that's our main coil. And then this white one is our center tap. So white and black on this particular step motor will be discarded. We'll just wire up these other 4. I'm actually going to just unplug this guy here. So I want it to be a standard header pin here. So if you'll remember, I was measuring on this one and white and black were the ones that were going away. They're kind of in a different order here, but just so that I can keep track here, I'm going to cut these a little shorter. So white and black are not going to be used. And I'm using number 18 wire here. It's pretty big. It's not going to be fun to work with, but at least I know for sure I'm not going to run into an area where I have low voltage going to my steppers because of the wires, or there's too much resistance on the wires. So they suggest 20 gauge or 22 gauge, but I happen to have these. These are one better. Alright, so for starters, I'm using a Ramp Board Electronics. This is power that's coming from my PC power supply that I modified. And this power supply had this nice black mesh thing over the wires, so I recycled some of that. You can see I'm using one of those here. It actually makes it look really nice. This right here is just called loom. Maybe it's called split loom, but you can just jam the wires in there, and you can find this at an automotive store. Very handy stuff. Okay. The Y stepper motor, it plugs in up here. You can see there is a Y on the board there, and it just plugs right in there. This is the X stepper. And you can see that there is a X right here for the X stepper. There's two Z steppers plugged in here. I put the wrong connector on this. This is the thermistor on the hot end. And then this is the, but this connector works anyway. And this is the thermistor from the heat bed. As you can see, there's an extra slot here. If you had an extra hot end, this is where the extra hot end stepper motor would, you would need a driver, then you can plug it in here. This is the regular stepper motor for the extruder motor. Our three limit switches. I think if these were optical in stops, I think I would have soldered an extra set of header pins there so that we could power them. But I don't have that yet, but I can always add that later. You can see that there's an X, Y, and a Z written on the board. Power, there are two powers. One of the two is for things like the heaters, and then the other one is for the steppers or something. Anyway, they're all connected back to the same supply. I have number 12 gauge wire here, and you probably need at least 12 to 14 gauge wire for your power supply wires. Otherwise, you might get too much resistance on the wires and get a low voltage. Now the screw terminals, these two are for the heater on the extruder. These two are for the heater on the hotbed. And this would be for a second hot end.